That's this low pressure. Some days I get up and I feel 71. Today I feel 71. My back is just trashed. Didn't do anything special. This is kind of the weird thing about it is some days my back will be okay, and then other days I have to have a cane to even get out of my chair. This is why gaming is my hobby. You know, you have to have something to keep your mind stimulated, right? So, plus, I mean, I've been a gamer my whole life. I doubt if I could ever quit. You know what I mean? They'll probably find me dead in my chair with a controller in my hand. So this is what I'm going to do. I watched the replay of some Borderland play that I had. And I noticed the color intensity. I'm hoping that you do too. Because that's what I'm seeing on the screen. This incredibly deep and dense color palette that's just beautiful compared to when I did the screen recording on my PlayStation with the Share app. All of that was gone. And so using the Share app defeats the entire purpose of me trying to convince you, look, you need to get an AWOL vision projector, an ALR screen, and up your gaming to the next level so that you're like me. I went back and played all of my old games on my Xbox because they looked so good. They looked so good. So I guess what I'll do is I'll play a level. I'll try to find a difficult level, something difficult. I'll play it on my screen and record it with my phone. And then I'll do the share on the same, you know, hopefully with the same. Maybe I'll kill myself just before I finish the mission so that I can go back and redo it again and show you the difference between what your PlayStation is putting out to my projector, okay? And what my projector is putting out onto my screen is two different things. Televisions are not capable. I don't care if it's micro LED or what it is. Unless you have those three pure colors, red, blue, and green, okay? All working on DLP chips, which are basically just micro mirrors. What you're getting is pure color on the screen. When you're mixing those lasers to make all of the color palette, you're getting a billion colors. And my phone just can't keep up. So what I'm going to put a light over here and maybe a light over here and see if I can trick my camera into not being so taken back when it gets dark. I've noticed that there are times when I'm recording the screen that it looks fantastic because it's daytime. The trouble with Borderlands, when it goes into a nighttime mode, you can't really do nighttime mode, can you? You can't really make it darker because people wouldn't be able to see. And so what they do is they shade the entire screen a dark blue. Or when it's sunset, they shade the entire screen with a red color. And that is when my iPhone has a problem. So it's not all the time. If you go into my comments, you're going to see me. I had to give this guy a hard time. Well, everyone knows that's what I do anyway. If you're going to come to my page and comment, you better have your fucking shit together, okay? If you're going to come to my page and tell me, oh, I'm an iPhone expert and an expert in everything Apple, that's what the guy said. The guy actually had the fucking balls to say, yeah, I'm an expert. I'm an expert at, okay, well, guess what? None of my other cameras have this problem. So your fucking expertise goes out the window. What, you're an expert at shitty cameras? Is that, what was your whole point of telling me I'm an expert and it's your problem? No. Okay, I have a 10-year-old camera sitting over there on my shelf that I've done experiments with and it looks beautiful. Even when they do the nighttime, daytime shift thing, it doesn't have a problem. My GoPro, when they do that same thing, it doesn't have a problem. You see, my iPhone is manipulating every photo and video I take to try to make it an Apple standard photograph or video. Now, I can change the exposure. While I'm filming, I can reach up here right now and flick down, and I can change my exposure, but I can't up or down my color. You know what I mean? I can't change tint. I can't really do anything other than change my exposure. And the very second I try to adjust my exposure, the detail starts going away. I noticed it right away. I picked a spot on the ground that had some clutter. I'm looking at the clutter, and I moved it 0.1 lighter, and the detail immediately went away. So that's not going to work either. My best hope here is to place lights. I might even have to buy dedicated, I'm going to film with my iPhone camera lights on each side of my screen. Okay, because it defeats the purpose using the share app. Not that it doesn't work. It does work. It's very limited time-wise, but it does work. You saw that it worked. But what you're seeing is what my PlayStation would put out to an LED TV, because you're watching it on your phone or whatever device you're using. Okay, when I watch it on my projector screen, from the YouTube app, it just looks like regular gameplay. All of that magnificent deepening and richness of color is gone. If you look at where I'm playing, even it was a daylight shot, I'm headed towards the prison. I'm up on the overpass and I'm having a shootout with these guys, and it's daylight and everything looks normal. And I'll bring up my menu and wow. The richness of the color and just the menus. I'm sure you notice it. You must notice it. It's so glaringly obvious. If you haven't, go back and look when I pull up my menu or I look at a weapon on the ground, how intense and deep the color is. And so, yeah, using the share app defeats the purpose. So I'm going to find a way of using my phone. My other cameras are inconvenient, to say the least. I might be able to use my GoPro when I pull my sim rig over, and I'll get my tall tripod out. I have a very tall tripod that sits at 5 feet, and I can look over myself and get the whole screen and me in one shot, and you'll be able to see how big it looks. That's going to be pretty cool. But the point is the color. Color in when I'm gaming and playing or even watching a movie or anything else, the color depth, clarity, and intensity is kind of like the music in a movie or good acting in a movie, okay? If the music, if the score is poor, even if the action or what's going on at the moment is good, it takes you away. If the acting is bad, no amount of great music is going to improve that, right? If you got low production quality, no music is going to fix that. You know what I mean? It's the color intensity. Go back and look at my gameplay there at Borderlands, and you'll see exactly what I mean. When I'm in the shadows and it's nighttime looking thing, you'll see that everything has a tint. That's Borderlands doing that. That's not my projector doing that, or really my iPhone camera doing that. My iPhone is picking up all of that blue that they've put over to make it look like it's, you know, going into evening. So I'll do both today, just as a comparison, so you can see what I mean by the color and why I want to actually film my ALR screen. And that might have something to do with it too, okay? The ambient light rejecting screen is built a certain way. If I take my iPhone and go like this and wave it around, you know, back here you can see on that TV, you can see that light right there. That light is that light. And everything in behind this television is reflected really clearly, okay? But you can't see those lights on my screen. You can't see anything behind me there. See? So it works differently. It's actually a printed surface with little angles. So the light comes in, it strikes in the center, it goes up and then is projected directly back out at me. And I'm thinking that could have something to do with the poor performance of my phone camera. We'll have to see. So I'm going to do some more experimenting, but I'm not going to do the share thing anymore, other than a comparison of color with my projector.